Thank you. Good morning, all of you. I am Srinivas, Assistant Professor from IT Department and presently working in St. Martin's Engineering College. Today, I would like to give a demo on small topic like cyber laws and ethics. Before that, nowadays we have seen very rapidly on cyber security in the worldwide, right? So, to implement and to avoid these cyber security crimes in the worldwide, we have implemented cyber laws and ethics. So, what do you mean by cyber law? Generally, the cyber law is nothing but we can say that it is an internet law. The common word for this one cyber law is called as internet law. Internet law. So, in this internet law, we have a relationship between a technological and also and electronic elements. In this elements, what we are talking about electronic elements consist of, we have different types of things. The things are a software and a hardware and a information system. Right, these are the things that comes under electronic elements. So, whatever the cyber crimes has been occurred, only this can be occurred to these elements only. Right. So, these are the things the cyber security can be, the crime has been done to the cyber people, and also this laws will be implemented for those persons who have done the cyber crimes. Right. So, coming to the cyber, we are talking about ethics. So, ethics nothing but ethics considered as a standards. So, in this standards, this classified into two types. The first one is called as welfare standards. The second one is called as study and development standards. Right. So, the first one is called as welfare standards. Welfare standard. And the second one is called as study and development standard. Study and development standard. So, what are the things comes under this welfare standard and also study and development? So, in the welfare standards, it is completely related to a society, benefits to the society. Benefits to the society. And also, the things comes under study and development ethics comes under, we can say that behavioral. Behavior or feelings or anything. So we have things like the right to, generally we are talking about right to speech, right to freedom of expression, right to have privacy. Privacy, these are the things we will follow when we are talking about ethics. So, ethics are the standards which are concerned with cyber laws and ethics. So, we will see the small measures which comes under this cyber crimes. We'll talk about measures which are related to cyber crimes. The first one is called as encryption. We are talking about measures. The first one is called as encryption and the second one is called as synchronized password. Synchronized password. The third one is called as firewalls. And the fourth one is called as attacks. Right. So, if we are talking about encryption, these are the measures which are commonly done in the cyber crimes. So, we are talking about encryption. Encryption nothing but
It is one of the human readable form. We have a plain text. We have plain text. This is a plain text. We can say that this is a human readable form, which is converted into a cipher text. This cipher text unreadable form. This is readable form. This is unreadable form. Again, it is converted into a converted into decryption. So the plain text, which is encryption, is transferred to the plain text. Human readable form can be converted into a cipher text. Unhuman readable form. Again, this cipher text can be converted into decryption. We can access this decryption using a private key. Right? This can be accessed using a private key. So that we can use again this readable form of this plain text. And this encryption standards. And the second one is synchronous passwords. Whenever we are using any password to any mail ID, we need to change 30 to 60 days randomly so that we can avoid any cyber crimes. So suppose when you log into the other bank, internet banking, it is asked to send OTP like that. So whenever you want to change the password for this one, 30 to 60 days you need to change each and every time the password will be changed. So this can be done by users and also host token. This can be done by users side and also host token. So this is called as, so that we can avoid this synchronous password. This can, when you log into the system, what happens? The login session can be for one time only. Session can be idle for one time only. Then this is a synchronous password. The third one is called as firewalls. Firewalls are the wall which is in between a system and a intruders. This is the wall between system or software and intruders. So this is the wall between system and intruders. In this, which are, when we are using any firewalls, this will protect to leakage of any documents. Suppose we are using any Wi-Fi, our college website. So other websites cannot be accessed by our faculty. This is an example, best example for this one. So we cannot use any other websites. Only like maybe normal websites we can use for this. Like for this, when we are using this firewalls, right? So another example is when you are logging to any system, like in the outside Wi-Fi, unsecured Wi-Fi. Public Wi-Fi. So this will also have an effect to this using this firewalls, right? So unsecured Wi-Fi, if you use the automatic, the password, whatever you are using, username and password will be hacked by the cybercrime people. So you need to have some protected software password only. So this is called as firewall. And attackers, nothing but when you are, people are using internet access like unknown websites and unknown privacy in the internet centers. So people are logged into the particular systems. So the systems which are using the internet caves, those are not genuine web softwares, right? If you are using any Windows 10 software, those people are using not genuine software, it is piracy software. So if you are using any software which is genuine only, we can protect from the cyber crimes. So whatever the username and password they are using this pirated software, so that will be hacked by this cyber crime people. So these are the things comes under the measures of this cyber crime things. And next one, is threats. What are the threats? We will talk about the threats. Threats are different. We have different types of threats. The first one is called as malware. And the second one is called as phishing. And the third one is DOS attack. Fourth one is MITM. And fifth one is
digital signatures. Digital signatures.
These are things comes under threats. So first we are talking about a malware. What is a malware? It is a malware consists of we can say that virus, worms, threats, and ransomware. That comes under this malware. So this is a software which is used to send entire complete your system. So this malware will be sent to entire system. What happens? Whatever the data which is inside your system will be hacked by the cybercrime people, right? So it consists of virus and worms and ransomware and spyware. You can say that spyware. These are the softwares which are used to destroy any type of a computer, or it may be anything, computers or systems or network, right? So this one comes under malware. The second one is a phishing. What is a phishing? It is one of the fake communication between a system and the other person. This is a fake communication. Fake communication between a person, right? So what happens in this phishing? Suppose when you are logging with any internet banking there, instead of having some SBI online internet bank, there some number or some letter will be changed. So we cannot identify that particular number or any letter. So instead of typing that one, generally we will search in that Google, right? What happens? It is going to something where it shows from like the that is a fake website, right? Fake website. Suppose SBI online banking is there, instead of yes, something will be different, the letter or some symbol will be different. We cannot identify that particular letter or number. So instead of searching for a general software, internet blocking banking, we will use this. If you click on that particular login button, it goes somewhere, and whatever the passwords, username password will be submitted to that cybercrime people. So that the data will be still by that person. So this called as phishing, nothing but a fake communication, right? And the next one is DOS attacks, denial of service attacks, where this can be attacked to, this is one of the cyber attacks that affect to the complete network or software. This can be attacked completely to the network or software. So what happens? In this we have one of the botnet is there. Botnet. So botnet is one of the attack which is infected completely your entire system or software through overall the network, right? This is a device attack. This can be completely infected using the distributed denial of service. Distributed denial of service. This is one of the attack. And the next one is MITM, man in the middle attack. You can say that man in the middle attack. What happens? This is one way. Generally, we are communicating with other people. These are two-way communication between a person and the system, right? These are two-way communication. What happens in this man in the middle attack? So, suppose the person is logged in. What happens here? Logged into the some online website. So, he has to pay some amount to the particular website, a payment gateway. There, these people are entering into that particular gateway. That has been, the gateway has been somewhat, the traffic will be acquired. More traffic will be acquired here. What happens is the more traffic there, the person wants to steal the data of that particular payment gateway numbers. So there, the data will be taken by this other party, right? In the same way, they can be, the data can be lost by the people. So such type of cyber capture has been occurred, right? This is the threat. And next one is digital signatures. Whenever people are using these digital signatures, so in the banking systems, these people are using some separate algorithms. Different algorithms are using in the banking systems to use the customer signature. So like different cryptographic algorithms are using to have some digital signature of a customer, different customers. And
Thank you.